I want to show you how to do today is to measure the bore of your Martini Henry rifle by slugging it. Now, if you have a standard British-made Martini Henry, you know, one of the Mark IV series, such as this one I purchased from IMA, or a Mark II, your bore diameter is going to be 468, and you can be sure of that. Now, if you have a I need to clarify that. If you have a Mark IV, your bore diameter could be as large as 472. Apparently, there were some variances in their barrels, but 468 to 472 on your Mark IVs. The larger diameter is only going to affect accuracy. Now, what I want to show you on the wall behind me is a Nepal Catch Francotte and a Nepal Catch Martini Gahendra. Now, those rifles were made in Nepal by the Nepal Smiths. And the bores on those rifles vary. The upper rifle, I slugged the bore on that, and the bore diameter is 457. The lower rifle, the Gahendra, myself and a friend of mine, we both bought ours the same day, and the bore diameter on his is 457. The bore diameter on mine is 451. So there's a variance there where he could be buying ammo for his gun that he knows is going to be fine for his gun. I'm going to try to shoot it and my gun's going to blow up. Know your weapon, know your bore, and be safe. That's the idea behind this. All right? How to slug your weapon. All right. The first thing you're going to want to do, well, is make sure your weapon's safe. All right? You open your action, you check your chamber, make sure it's safe. Then you take your your lead slug, I refer to it as a bullet. Take your cleaning rod out. You don't want to destroy your cleaning rod by accidentally hitting it with a hammer. Take a little bit of grease, apply it to the inside of your muzzle. Take a little bit of grease and apply it to the outside of the bullet or the slug you're going to use. Use a pure soft lead slug that is larger than the diameter you believe your bore to be. Make sure it's a lot larger. This is a 50 caliber lead slug. It's a Maxi Hunter. I'm using it only because I know it is pure lead and I know it is larger than the bore of the rifle that I'm using. Take a hammer such as this one. It is a soft face hammer. It's got a plastic face on it. You could use a brass hammer, but I don't know if I'd still want to use a brass hammer. I suppose it wouldn't hurt. All right, after you made sure your weapon was safe, unloaded, you've removed your cleaning rod, tap it in. All right, I'm going to grab a brass rod here. Finish tapping it in. I really need a shorter rod. Hopefully you'll have a rod a little bit shorter than this. It doesn't take much. The last few hits really didn't take much effort at all. It was just tapping it through. And you can use your cleaning rod or use a regular rod to push it into the chamber. This doesn't take much. Now, once you get the slug hammered through your bore, the measuring your bore diameter is not the same as slugging other rifles. You might be familiar with slugging bore diameter and you might think that all this is redundant information. Well, for a Martini Henry rifle, the difference is the Henry rifling. You're going to want to take and measure your slug a little bit differently. And the way you do that is after you take your slug and you tap it through your bore, you put it between the jaws of your calipers, like so. Now you rotate the slug. You rotate it, and the largest diameter that you come up with while rotating it between the jaws of your calipers, applying light pressure to it, is the diameter of your bore. My Mark IV slug's at 468, which is standard for a British weapon. Like I said, the Mark IIs, Mark IVs, 468, you can be safe firing 468 diameter bullets through those weapons. If you have a Nepal Catch Francotte or Gahendra that you've bought from IMA or you've gotten perhaps somewhere else online, measure your bore. It'd be good also to make a chamber casting. I'm not going to show you how to do that today, but if you made a chamber casting, it'd give you a little bit more information on your weapon. Now, this is assuming you've already had your gun checked out by a gunsmith and you know it's safe to shoot, and now you're looking for the appropriate ammo for your gun. So get a lead slug that you know is going to be larger than your bore. Tap it in after it's been greased, rotate it in the jaws of your calipers. Can't think of anything else to tell you with regards to this. It's not hard to do. It is necessary considering the variances on your Nepal Catch rifles that were actually made in Nepal, your Francottes and Gahendras. You want to be safe. I don't want to hear of anybody's gun blowing up on them because they used the wrong bullet. But it's not hard to do, and hopefully you'll take the time to do that if you buy one of these weapons. So be safe. Know your weapon. Know your bore size. If there's anything else I can think of that is necessary information to people who might want to shoot their Martini Henrys or these Nepal Catch weapons, I'm fascinated with them, so I'm making videos on it myself and Iraq veteran 8888. Hopefully you found this informative. If you subscribe to me online, the next time I come up with something I think might help you out, I'll make a video of it and you'll see it. So be safe and enjoy your weapons, enjoy shooting, and have fun.